Hello learners, welcome to the video lecture on subject heat and mass transfer. In today's session, we are going to discuss overall heat transfer coefficient in case of heat exchanger. Please see my previous video on the topic fouling factor in heat exchanger so that here you will understand the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient. In fouling factor, we have studied that it is a undesirable phenomenon of deposition of undesirable material on the tube surface which may cause the low heat transfer rate. So we have to consider that fouling factor in case of overall heat transfer coefficient. Now let us understand what is meant by overall heat transfer coefficient. It is desirable and convenient to combine the various thermal resistances that are encountered in the heat transfer from one fluid to another in the heat exchanger. It means while heat transfer from a hot fluid to cold fluid, what are the different resistances are there, we have to count them and combine them together and we called it as a overall heat transfer coefficient. Such a combination is achieved by using the heat transfer equation as shown below. The equation is Q is equal to UA delta T, where Q is the rate of heat transfer which is having unit watts, A is the area of heat flow which is having unit of meter square, delta T is the temperature difference between the fluid, hot temperature and cold fluid temperature, which is having the unit of degree centigrade, and U is known as a overall heat transfer coefficient. Its unit is watts per meter square Kelvin. Now what are the different resistances are there? Let us understand this diagram first. In this diagram, this is a tube which separates the hot fluid and cold fluid. Let us understand, if hot fluid is passing through the tube and cold fluid is present outside the tube, then there are different kinds of resistances which may occur. And one more criteria is considered, the fouling may occur from inside as well as outside. Now let us consider what are the different resistances. Number one, convection resistance on the inner surface of the tube of heat flow from fluid to wall, means when the heat is flowing from this tube to the wall, we have considered the convective heat transfer coefficient, which is called as RI. Next resistance is due to the inside fouling. Whatever the deposits are present in hot fluid are get deposited on the inside surface of the tube, and we have to consider the fouling factor of RFI. Next resistance is due to the conduction through the solid surface wall. It means this tube is made up of a solid material, either aluminium, copper or steel. Then heat is transferring from this surface to this surface by the phenomenon of conduction, so we have to consider the conduction resistance. Next, resistance due to outside fouling, means whatever the impurities are present in the cold water are get deposited on the outside surface, we have to consider the fouling from outside. And finally, from tube surface to the cold fluid, we have to consider the convection resistance, which is having the value of RO. We know that heat transfer Q is equal to delta T divided by RTH, and RTH is nothing but the thermal resistance. So inside convective resistance is referred by 1 upon AIHI. Resistance due to the inside fouling is considered by this value AIHSI. Then resistance due to the conduction for the tube is considered by this formula. Then resistance due to the fouling from outside is referred by 1 upon AOHSO. And finally, the convection resistance for outside surface is referred by 1 upon AOHO. So this is the consideration of overall heat transfer coefficient in case of fouling. The overall heat transfer coefficient depends on the fouling factor. Number one, flow rate, water flow rate, that is hot fluid as well as cold fluid, properties of the fluid, thickness of the tube material, means conduction resistance depends on thickness of the tube, surface condition of the tube, means depend on the fouling rate, how much it affects the heat transfer, and geometrical configuration of the heat exchanger. This is the design criteria of the heat exchanger. This table represents the value of overall heat transfer coefficient. While designing the heat heat exchanger, we have to consider this overall heat transfer coefficient, and the various fluid combinations are mentioned in this table. If you are using both fluid, hot as well as cold fluid as a water, then overall heat transfer coefficient may vary in this range. If you are using water and oil, this range is given. If you are using this for air and gases, then this is the value. Means if we are using the different fluids like water, water, oil, water, air, water, then the values of overall heat transfer coefficient must vary in this range. Thanks for watching.